Back to North Carolina for the exciting final of the USCA Golf Croquet National Championships. Of the 15 or 20 clubs in the mountains west of Asheville, four have gotten together to put on these nationals. Sapphire Valley, Chattooga, Highhampton, and today, Highlands Falls. We zoom in on Highlands Falls, and you can see that they have a gorgeous croquet lawn to the left of the parking lot there that can handle two courts that look like this from Brian Hovis's drone the morning of the semifinals when Sherif Abdelwahab beat Blake Fields 2-0 and Matthew Essick won over Tom Balding 2-1. So now those two meet in the final later the same day when the shadows are gone. It's a little cloudier. That white tent on court one is where Brian is set up, and Paul is up on the hillside off of corner four. This again is the USCA Golf Croquet National Championships in May of 2022. Takes a crowd to put this on. Jeff Sue is the tournament director, ably assisted by Eileen Sue and by Michael Albert. Michael is the tournament manager, and again, the videographers are Brian with some assistance from Paul on this one. This event and this channel are both sponsored by the United States Croquet Association, where you can get everything you need to know about this great sport of ours, whether it's golf croquet, AC, US rules, or even nine wicket. I think it's about 3 in the afternoon, a little overcast, pretty windy at times, but obviously quite comfortable. Sherif won with black, so Matthew gets to come in and choose his color. He's going to do yellow. He's going to go check and see who's blocking whom. And for the first time, we get to use a second camera. Looks like yellow doesn't need to be cleared because he only has a jump shot. If he misses that, blue's all set. I think he wanted blue to come straight down toward hoop two so that it wouldn't be able to clear red in front of hoop one. They both tend to put these blocking balls as close to the striker ball as they can, I think, to try to prevent a jump shot. This next clip is from Paul Neubecker's camera up on the hillside to give you an idea of what Brian Hovis's perspective is and to give Brian some screen time. A shot that good from over 105 feet has every right to be definitive. Unless it's answered by one of commensurate quality. Yeah. Come on, admit it. You wanted to see it again. And that left hand is the closest we get to an end zone dancing croquet. Unless, of course, you've seen Joe Yoder play. This is getting ridiculous. I think of these videos as teaching tools. All I'm learning from this one is what's possible. Not much that I can take home myself. Line shots on 1, 3, 7, 9, 13. Pretty standard stuff. Line shot on 5. Not so much.
Come on!
Thank you.
again. Yep, ready. Want something over there, Sherif?
Yes, please. Hello.
I think both their mallets should be checked for hidden laser guidance devices.
I didn't see where this went out, Sherif.
Yeah.
Oh, dear. Self.
To borrow a phrase from my grandson Irving, holy moly, YouTube would strike the phrase I want to use. Interplanetary clearances, smart positional play. Admittedly, Sherif missed a couple of hoops, but Matthew was in another dimension around the hoops in this 7-0 second game. The crowd is so relieved that they're going to a third. So give us a like, subscribe, hit that notification bell. The decider comes out in a couple of days.